Mocking plays an important role in writing the unit test cases as well as integration test cases for any application. Mockito is a Java library that helps in mocking the classes as well as external dependencies that are there, right? So in this video, I'm going to explain everything about the mocking and Mockito, right? So let's see what we have covered so far in microservices testing. So this is the GitHub page where you will get all the source code as well as course plan. So first video we have discussed why do we need this testing and all those stuffs. Second, this is the playlist where I have explained about JUnit 5 unit testing in detail. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Mockito, right? So let's go ahead and start step by step. So first, see why mocking is needed. So these are the few lines that I have written. So a unit test should test functionality in isolation. Side effects from other classes or the system should be eliminated for unit test if possible, right? So let me show you this with a diagram. So if you are in old application, which is monolithic application, you will be having a single monolithic application and your application will be composed of small modules, right? So which individual team would be developing and they will be writing the unit test cases or integration test cases for their own module, right? And to make the complete application, each module is interacting with each other, right? So these interactions that they are doing, so while this module is being unit tested, if I talk about only this module, so this module is being unit tested. So there are classes, right? And here you have methods. Inside this, you are calling other modules. So this dependency, while doing the unit testing for this class, and inside class, you have methods, right? While writing the unit test cases for the methods, you should mock these dependencies to isolate this method, right? So that the execution of this method is not dependent on any other method, any other class or any other outer dependency, right? So this we try to achieve. So this is about the monolithic application, but if we are in microservice architecture, so we will be having different services S1, S2, S3, S4, SN. And there will be one coordinator or even they will be interacting with each other and one service will be calling other to make the complete application. And each service is being developed by each team, each developer. And even if you are using any paid service, so it is possible that it is completely developed by another company and you are just using those one, right? And in your service, if this is the service that you are putting under test and you are going to write the unit test for this service, there will be classes, right? And inside classes, you will be having methods. And these methods, you will be writing the unit test. So whatever methods are calling this outer service that is there, so you should cut that dependency while unit testing. So how we can do that? So this how we can do this, that answer lies in mocking, right? So we should mock those dependencies that are being called from that particular method which we are unit testing, right? So there is a technical term about test doubles to mock these things. There are different kinds of test doubles. Let's see one by one. Test doubles are test replacement of real external dependencies inside a method which are calling another class method, another dependency. Those are replaced by these test doubles. So these are called test doubles. These are of different kinds that we can use. First is the dummy object, passing around but never used. So if you have a class, so if I write this one, and inside this you have method 1, var 1, var 2, okay. This is the class, that this is the method that you have. It is taking two parameters, var 1 and var 2. These can be object, and this is the method body where these var 1 and var 2 are interacting, right? So the dummy object is just to complete this one. So for example, there is scenario that you are testing if block, any if block inside this method you are putting under test, and where this var2 is not used, only var1 is used. So you will create the actual object of this var1, but var2 you can pass as null, right? Because it is not needed at all. So that is called dummy object, right? So you can pass null just to fill the gap They are passed just to fill the gap, but they are never used while unit testing. Second is fake objects. Like, so for example, memory DB for actual DB. So in your application, if you're connecting to the actual DB in real-time application, but by unit testing, you can fake that DB connection with the H2 memory database or any other array list or any other dummy implement. These are fake objects where you replace the actual one with the less complex one, right? So that you can use easily. Next comes the stub class. So if you have an interface or class which you are actually using in your real application, but when you are stubbing it, you create the dummy implementation of, you will create another class which will be implementing this interface or extending this class, and they will be overriding the actual method that are there in interfaces, right? And these overridden methods will return the values that we need for our unit test cases. All right, so these are known as the stub classes. So these are stub classes, stub objects. So what you do, you initialize those stub classes, you exercise what you want to do, and then you verify the behavior that it is expected or not. So this is the flow that it goes with the stub class, and it is there to test the data. Mainly it is there to test data. Next is the mock objects. Stub class and mock objects are related. So difference is, it is important to understand the difference. Here mock objects is also somewhat like this, that you have interface class, but you mock those objects, you create those mock objects and define the behavior that are there, right? So you initialize those classes that are there, you set the expectation for those, what they should return for a particular method, and you exercise the unit test cases, you exercise the test that you want to perform, and you verify that whether the expected behavior is the actual behavior or not. It is there to basically test the behavior of the application, right? So these are the few topics about test doubles which are there to replace the actual and external dependencies, right? So here one point to note is that while doing the unit test cases, one of these can be used, whether we can use a dummy object, fake objects, stub class or mock objects, whatever fits in a particular situation, right? So we can use the combination of all of these as per the situation. But if I talk about the stub class and mock object, so mock object is basically there to is used frequently instead of a stub class, because in a stub class you have to write many line of codes, but with the mock objects you can do the same thing with few lines of code, and there are different libraries that give you the facility to mock the behavior, right? So stub classes significance is little less than the mock object. So let's see what is next. So Mockito. Coming to the Mockito, Mockito is the Java library. It is the mocking framework for Java. Mockito allows the convenient creation of substitutes for real objects for testing purposes. So these substitutes are the mock objects, right? So how this Mockito is used? You add the mock dependencies that are there. You execute the code in the classes and you verify the behavior that are there, and verifying behavior means you set the expectation and you get the actual one, and you compare both of these if they are equal or not. Based on that, you mark the test cases pass or fail, right? It's all about the theory in mocking in general and Mockito Java library. So now let's go ahead and see some code examples. So this is a simple project, calculator project, that I already have created while explaining the unit test cases. So this is the build.gradle where I have added this test implementation dependency about Jupyter. The way we have added this JUnit Jupyter dependency, we can add the Mockito library as well. So to add the Mockito library, you have to write this one the way we have written this Jupyter library, right? So this is the org.mockito, Mockito core, and this is the version, right? So when you add this dependency and refresh the project, so this is the build Gradle build tool that I'm using. You can use any build tool that you want. For example, there are Maven and Ant also. And to get this dependency, you can just Google search and you will get the Maven repository about this one. So how to add the Maven as well, right? So this Mockito explanation is not dependent basically on this build tools, but they are there just to add the dependency. So when I added this dependency and allowed the dependency to be downloaded, I got this dependency, right? Mockito core here. And this open, these are the some transitive dependencies that has come along with this Mockito. So we have added only two lines of this dependency. We got all of this dependency, right? So now our application has Mockito library added. Now it's time that we write some code. So let's write some test class, some source classes that are there, so that we can show the demo about the Mockito. So this is the my service class that I have created, right? And this is the external service example. For example, it is there. That is why I have named it so. And this external service is inside this my service. To create the instance of my service, I have to pass the instance of external service. And inside this my service, I have this validate method. Inside this, I have this logic that if ID is null, it has to throw runtime exception, and otherwise it will call the validation external service validation data. If ID and if the return value is not null, it will return true. If these are not the cases, then it will return false. Let me show you the external service now. So this has nothing fancy, but this only get validation data, which is accepting this ID and returning the some dummy string. In real world application, these things are going to be very different, but idea about the mocking that I want to show are going to be the same, right? So if you see, this external service method is being used here. So we will mock this behavior. So I'm going to put this method under test, and inside this we have written this business logic, this one, right? And this not equal or something, right? Based on, and this is the outer dependency that is there, and I have to mock this method here, right? So let me go ahead and create the test class and show you this. So this is the test one, test package, and these are the demo tests that I already have written, explained to you in the previous classes. So this is the mock and this is the Mockito demo. It is the just class that I have created, and all of these things that I'm going to write here. I'm going to put under test this my service, right? And to create the instance of this my service, I need the external service to take this one as well, right? And now set up, create the instances of these one inside before each, right? There are different ways that you can create. So we will be having, if I want, I will be having this actual instance here, new my service, and inside this I have to pass this external service, right? Now we have this my service, but I have not created the instance of this external service. So there are many ways that we can create the instance of this one. Let's see the first one. So first we can use the annotation that is mock, right? To get this @mock annotation working, I have to write one initialization rule that is there. So Mockito annotation dot open mocks, and inside this I have to call this, means whatever this class is inside this Mockito demo. So anything that is added with this annotation will be mocked automatically, right? So this is the one way that I can mock this one. And then when I'll be running this one, we will be having this external service as mock instance of this external service, not the actual instance, but mock instance. So this is the one way that I can add. What is the second way that I can add? So there is one method that we can use. So Mockito. So see, these Mockito classes are coming from the Mockito library that we have added, mock, and inside that I have to pass the type of class that is there, dot class, and that's it. So if I am if I so we have to use one of these, right? So whether I want to use the @mock annotation, then I have to use this line. If I do not use the @mock annotation, then I have to use this one. Both are going to do the same job, right? So I have to, so I can comment out one of these. So let me comment out this one, right? So this is the instance that I have created using this mocked external service, right? And to create this my service instance, there is one annotation that we can use as well for that. So if I do not want to use this one, I can use the @insect mocks. So if I use this annotation with this my service, so whatever mock objects are here, right? If at runtime it will be inspected that my service has dependency about this external service, and inside this class I have the mock instance of this external service that will be automatically added into this my service, right? So again, if I am using this new my service, I should not use this @insect mocks because they are going to do the same job. If I am using @insect mocks, I should not use this new my service. So let me go ahead with this one, right? So with this annotations, right? So let's go ahead and write first test, right? So void test one, test annotation putting here, and now I have to my service I have, and I have to use validate, and anything, for example, I'm passing here name, some ID, some name, some string here, and I have to assert this one, right? So I have to compare assert true. So by now you know how to why I'm doing this. If you have followed the previous classes that were there, so my service validate, so what it is going to do, my service will call this validate method, which will internally call the get validation data and will give the result, right? So here I am expecting that this method will give some result and it will be not equal, and we will get the true result, right? So let's see how it is going, right? So my service, so if I execute this one, I will be having this instance, but this class is going to fail because I have not defined what the validate method is doing. So let me run this one first and show you what error it is giving. Yes, assertion failed error, because we were expecting that if I pass something here in external service, it should return this one, but it is returning null, because it is not null. If the case is it is not null, it should have true, but it is null. That is why we are getting false. Let's see how we can fix this. So now at this moment, Mockito comes into picture here, right? So we have this external service, and see this line very carefully. So we have van, then Mockito.van, and then what class that is there, and then validate get validation data, and I am passing here the exact value that I am passing here, and then return some value. So what it is, what I am doing here actually, this line, what we are writing here, external service get validation data, I am passing this string, so it should return always this string that is there, whatever return type of this get validation data, that should come here under this one, then return, right? So no matter what input that I am passing here, it is going to always return this, but in actual case, what it is returning this one, but I want this to be returned here, right? So if I run this again, so it will get the value of this one and our test will pass. Here, now it is passing here. So now we have tested the data, now we can test the behavior as well. So we have, for that we have verify method, Mockito dot verify. So what I want to verify external service, and then I want to call times. So here I can pass that it is called one time. So verify method is taking two arguments here. First, the behavior that I want to test, and second, how many times it was called throughout the execution of this validate method. And then get validate data, and here is string. I have to pass the exact mocking that were there, right? So I have to pass it here. So here we are doing two things. We are testing the data as well as we are verifying the behavior. So double testing. Alright, so it means what we wanted, it the behavior was same, right? So it's all right. So if you put any other value here, 1, 2, 2, 3 or 0, it is going to fail, because in throughout the execution of this test, it was called only once. So it is not about that this validation, when this validate method is called, at that time, how many times it is called, right? So this it is testing. So just to give you the demo about this. So if I say this my service, and if I say that this one, I'm just putting a call here, right? So now if I execute the test here, this line will fail because now it is being called two times. See, it is failing, right? So wanted one time, but post two times, right? So this is how we can test the behavior. So remove this one. So this is the first test. Let's see the second scenario. So before proceeding to the second test, let me show you one more example in the same test that is there. So this is about the Mockito only. So here in this example, in the current one, we hard coded this value. What input that it can take this get validation data, but what is the problem with this one? So if I change this one, it is going to fail because it is not same as this one, right? So if I run this again, it is going to fail because behavior is not mocked for this argument, but for this one. How we can fix this one? So there is one more method under Mockito, that is AnyString, right? So argument matches, it takes any string. So here it is a string, but I can pass any integer, any double, any data type, any object, any class. So what we are saying that get validation data, if there is anything which is of a string type, it should return always some value. It should always return some value, right? So if I give Arvind 1, 2, 3 or any parameter that is a string, it will pass at all the time. But here, now this is passing, but this one is failing because here we are fixing this one, right? So now this validation data is there for this validate one, right? So now it will pass. And here also, this line also, if you are using, so actually when you are writing the actual test cases, you should test the behavior this way, but if you want the other way, it is there. So get validation data that we have. So you have any string here, you can pass the same thing here. So anything you change here, that doesn't matter. So it will call this one, that this get validation data for any string that is passed, it will be called one times. So it will validate the things accordingly. So I hope the point you are getting that I want to explain. So the arguments that you are passing and the result that it is returning and how the behavior you are testing that one, right? Now coming to test two. So these are the few lines that I already have written. So the difference is here. So I have written here two lines, two mocking lines that I have written here, and here I am validating this one. So there may be some cases some situation that you want different output from external party based on the input. So we can do that as well. So if you are writing two lines, so you should not use any string, but the actual data that you want and the respective result that you want from there, right? So here I am doing the same thing here. So when external service will get the string as true, it will return this string true. So when you are passing null, it is going to return null. So in case of null, what it is doing, my service, it is throwing an exception here, and you know how to test the exception, right? So assert throws, and here it is throwing runtime exception. So here we can test two behaviors at the same time, right? So get validation data for true, it is being called only once, right? So here actually if we are not passing anything here, so if I show you this verify here, by default it is taking one time, right? So if the interaction is more than one time, then you can pass the second argument here, otherwise by default it is going to take one. So if I run this one, it should pass, because in case of null, it is returning null, and our service will throw exception in that case. Yeah, both the cases are passing here. Now coming to the third test. So in the third case, I'll be showing you how you can throw an exception. So it is possible for the sum here, this is extremely simple example where all the scenarios are not covered, but in actual scenario it is possible based on some input data, it is possible that your method outer word part is throwing some exception, right? So how we can mock that exception behavior? So this is how you can do. The same way earlier we were using then return, but in this case we are using then throw, and the type of exception that it is throwing. When you are passing this validate, it is throwing an exception, and the same thing will be propagated, right? So get validation data, in case of null it is throwing an exception, and you are passing the validation and it is asserting the same thing, right? So you can change this to any string in that case as well, it is going to throw an exception, so it will pass at that time as well. So now coming to test case number 4, it is about do return and do throw, right? So do return and do throw are same as when then. So this, the examples that we have seen, they are form of when then, and here we are showing the do return. So Mockito.do return method, first you have to return, specify the return value, then you have to say at what basis it should return this one. So just the sequence is changed, nothing else. If they are doing the same thing, why the library is not strict with this one, why they introduce this one? So the thing is that the things are changing by the time, so they are going towards behavior driven BDD, behavior driven development, and all those things. That is why they are introduced, right? So do return and do throw you can write like this. So and for example, when you have a particular method that is returning, that is not returning anything, which is void. If I introduce one more method here, which is void, and it is not doing anything specific, but it is just doing here. And in some cases, it is throwing some exception. So when your method is not returning anything, you cannot test that one, right? So the values you cannot test from there, but the exception scenarios you can test, and the behavior you can test. So what you can do, you can mock this one, do using this do throw exception and do return, and then you can test the interaction that we were testing here, that while executing that test, they are called as this number of times. And this time you have to rely this on interaction only, because this void is not returning anything. You cannot do the value comparison in that case. The next thing, so these are the just simple examples that are used very frequently while writing the actual test cases. That is why I have covered. So my Mockito library has many more things other than this one, but I'll be covering that in the subsequent videos where I'll be writing the actual test cases, right? And when talking about the mocking objects, the second thing I want to talk about is spy objects. So the difference between a spy object and mock object is, so in a single class you have multiple methods, right? And if you want to mock all the methods, then you have to use this Mockito @mock annotation or mock. But if you want the mixed behavior, you want some of the methods you want to call actual behavior, you want the actual behavior so that you can actually call those one, right? And for some of the methods you want to mock, in that case you can use this spy, right? So the spy object is same as the other one. How you here you have this @mock annotation, but other way you use spy @spy annotation, and here you have this mock, otherwise you use spy, right? The difference is this is the way that you can create the spy objects, right? So here comment this out so that we can keep the @mock one. So this is how you can create the spy objects, and using a spy object you can call the actual behavior as well as you can mock some of the methods the way we have mocked with @mock annotation, right? So this is the quick examples that I wanted to take from the Mockito library. So in the subsequent videos I'm going to explain in detail the mocking behavior and the realistic things from the Mockito library that will be used the integration test, and there are many more things that need not to be learned, right? So you should not learn the complete library, but the actual thing that you are going to use in your while writing the actual test. So this was all about the course that I wanted to show you. There are some limitation of the Mockito library as well. Let's see that. So Mockito library cannot mock the static methods and private methods. They are there in the classes, right? To increase the modularity and all those stuff. So when they come into picture, Mockito library cannot perform. So how to resolve this one? So there is one more library, that is PowerMock, that helps in mocking this one. And the problem with PowerMockito is it is not supported with JUnit 5. At the time of making this library, I have explored on the internet, PowerMock is not supported with JUnit 5. Right, so we have to, whenever static methods and private methods are there, we cannot mock, so we have to call those actually. And Mockito library cannot mock constructors, right? So the detailed limitation, that if you want to learn about that, so you can go to this link and learn more about it, right? So this is all about the Mockito library. So after this Mockito, next topic is writing microservice, which we will be using to write the unit test cases and code coverage integration and all those stuffs, right? Subsequently I'll cover all these topics, right? So guys, I'll see you in the next video with this topic. Till then, take care, bye bye.